No doubt it is a crisis here and across the country, but it's a crisis too many people ignore, in part because it falls into that category that would never happen to me or my family. News Channel 5's Chris Stewart is here with a warning from parents who confronted this crisis and lost their son. Chris.
Oh, Kelly, Betsy Wiles is a fighter who, like thousands of people in our viewing area, knows the pain of losing the most important fight of her life. This crisis we all face has left a hole in her family.
Family. Don't ever, ever give up.
Betsy Wiles still holds on to this letter she once read at a Narcotics Anonymous meeting.
Don't quit trying and keep the faith. Do one day at a time.
She's a victim of the opioid crisis, but she's never taken a pill. She's never put a needle in her arm. Still, this epidemic has destroyed her family.
In the NA meetings, they teach to teach you to take one day at a time. And with the death of our son, that's how we have to live, is one day at a time.
The Wiles were like so many of your neighbors. Betsy worked for years at a bank. Her husband, Jerry, is a retired Palm Beach County firefighter. And their son, Brian?
Very cheerful persons. Everybody loved them. He never did harm.
A fisherman, a hunter, a father, a husband.
He's a character. He's got his daddy's looks and my personality.
But like many in our backyard, Brian got hooked on opioids.
We as parents didn't have a clue.
The Wilds did everything they could to save their son. They went to meetings. They let Brian and his family move in for 4 years.
You start to think that maybe they've whipped this. But there is no whip in this. It stays with them for a lifetime.
Without their knowing, Brian slipped back into addiction.
They keep the secrets, which is what kills them.
In Brian's case, it was a batch of pills he bought on the street.
Overdose, intoxication.
It was some bad stuff.
In October, the 41-year-old father of two lost his fight. He became one of the more than 500 to die from opioids in Palm Beach County last year alone. The numbers, they mean nothing to the Wiles.
It's destroyed our lives.
Their son is gone, and now they're moving. They don't know where they're going, but Palm Beach County's too painful. Brian's ashes are coming with them.
He's close to us. We talk to him. We love him. We miss him. And we tell him that every day.
They will always carry the pain of what the opioid epidemic did to their family here.
I just don't know how to, I don't know how to get through it, actually.
There's no way to leave that behind.
Oh, God. You give birth to a child and you love it unconditionally, and then it dies. And to try to get through something like that, it rips your heart and your soul out.
You know, and Kelly, such a tough interview to do, and you can see even months later, the pain's still there. And, you know, so often we talk about how many people are dying from this opioid epidemic. But with, you know, each number, each statistic, you know, there are stories like this of people and families that have been impacted, you know, beyond the person who passes
away. And I think by putting faces to those statistics and then parents coming out and sharing their grief, I think it helps other families know they're not alone.
I hope so.
Exactly. So that was a very painful, but
yeah,
wonderful.
Story.
Yeah, exactly. Thanks for bringing it to us, Chris.
Absolutely.